This world has so much beauty. It's difficult to describe what it's like wading into the deafening roar of the crashing surf of the Pacific Ocean, or standing at the foot of a mountain set ablaze by the fall hues, or reclining on the white sand beaches of the Gulf Coast, or witnessing the sunset on swaying acres of wheat, or looking for the first time into the eyes of a newborn baby, or watching the wrinkled countenance of a life fully lived. There's so much right with this world, but there's also so much that's wrong. The use of lies and manipulation to obtain control, the exercising of violence on the innocent, the destruction of life in the name of rights, the pillaging of the weak, which is fueled by greed, the violation of human dignity and freedom incited by lust and perversion, the ignoring of desperate human need because of vain self-centeredness, the pain which leads to and results from addiction, the suffering of the impoverished. I could go on. Fear, sorrow, struggle, loss. There's so much wrong with this world, and at some point, something has to rise up from the deep places of our heart. A defiant, daring, righteously indignant declaration that enough is enough. Jesus came not only to save us into heaven, He saved us that we might manifest the culture of heaven in the earth. He didn't come only with a spiritual transformation, He came revealing a better way, the real way to be human. He came to make wrong things right, to restore that which had been lost in the devastating aftermath of sin. He came to deal in justice and mercy, and if it's His vocation, it's ours as well. Will you sit idly by in your nice, quaint youth ministry watching the world burn? Or will you courageously engage with the audacious belief that you are a carrier of the antidote for what ails this broken earth? We're the emissaries of hope. We're the trumpet of heaven proclaiming daringly that Jesus has come to take over. He's come to depose devils, to overthrow tyrants, to unseat greed, to impeach perversion, to swallow up violence and subdue self-centeredness. He's here to extract hypocrisy. And us, we're the sign and wonder of His great mercy, the evidence of His unending loving kindness. We're here to rehabilitate the addict, to rejuvenate impoverished people, to rebuild the terrorized heart and nurture the violated. We're here to soothe the enraged. We are agents of healing, donating hope and leading into wholeness. TYM, this is who we are, and this is what we do. And remember, this world does have so much beauty. How beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news. Enough is enough.